Welcome back to our Commitment 2012 coverage. Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney is on Palm Beach right now at a private fundraiser. Kathleen O'Toole joins us now from the newsroom. And Kathleen, on the Democratic side, I understand there's a new poll out today that shows President Obama not doing very well here in Florida.
Right, exactly. And this is at a time that the Republicans are going to be getting a lot of media coverage. This is all not lost on the Democrats.
He's one of us.
The top Democrat in the state has boots on the ground in Florida. Senator Bill Nelson talking citrus with political leaders in Fort Pierce.
A disease called citrus greening.
But the sour taste for the party right now, a new Quinnipiac University poll that shows President Obama struggling in Florida, lagging slightly if he were to go head-to-head with Mitt Romney.
There are some methodology problems in that poll, but the truth is that the president and Romney would be about tied.
Senator Nelson says it's just too early to put a lot of stock in such polls.
There can be a lot of things that happen, either good or bad. I think for the good, the economy is going to improve. For the bad, we could be in drug into a war with Iran.
Being in a statistical dead heat is something that the Obama camp is definitely taking notice of.
With a doctorate in political science, Northwood University's Kristen Stayhauer says it's no surprise that it'll be the economy that will influence voters.
At the end of the day, we'll see many issues come up, but the voters really do tend to vote their pocketbooks.
Florida is a big deal.
Senator Nelson says the party will be up and energized in his home state, one that with its size and swing voters is a political Goliath.
The conventional wisdom is that which candidate wins Florida is going to win the presidency.
All eyes on us. Now, Florida's been particularly hard hit by the economy, and that's another reason that an incumbent is not polling well. Tiffany, back to you.